over there, and here, like the
everybody's here for the not everybody. We're going to be going over to Annabella's for the rehearsal dinner tonight.
I like still have like I definitely remember like hearing the music and all that, but I don't think I
you know what I mean?
Thank
it's like sort of weird about Dreams, but it's just really weird.
Can you even read it?
Wow, that's a good last dude forever and ever.
Forever and ever.
No. The bow, I gave the bow to Mason, she gave her the dinosaur. That's how I saw it. I'm here.
No, ask for more.
No. Yeah. Hey.
No, you shouldn't know.
Oh,
maybe you should. It's our champagne
thing. Yeah.
How'd you know that?
Is it
the
flute coming out?
She's a witch. It's a wind instrument. It's a flute.
Oh, you're right.
Okay, we're here for Kim's wedding rehearsal and dinner. This is what everybody was looking at. I was wondering what the interest was. I was just pointing out to Debbie that's where we're having fresh baby duck for dinner tonight.
No plates.
Okay. Straight.
Try one.
Then I say a few words myself and we're ready for the heart of the ceremony.
Heading up to Annabella's. Okay, that's okay.
Kim and I would like to thank everyone for coming tonight. We're both extremely happy that families get to get together and have the opportunity to meet each other again and talk, and hopefully they'll extend it into tomorrow. We love each other very much. We're very excited for tomorrow, and I just wanted to have a chance to thank everyone for coming, and I think that's really it. So I think Kim's gonna play something else to say.
And we want to thank my future in-laws for being dinner for tonight. Thank you so much. I hope everything's great. I'm sure everything. And thank you so much.
All right.
She heard I walked back and I
just flipped.
And thank you to my parents for everything that you've done for our wedding, because we wouldn't be able to have the wedding that we're having. And to everybody that's helped. Like all my bridesmaids, Lisa's the best maid of honor that anyone could ever ask for. That probably wouldn't be so calm if it wasn't for her. So, and I know Yancy feels the same way about
absolutely. Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you.
The bucket of pumpkins has arrived, so we are good to go.
Who cares if the hair girl doesn't show up?
My bucket of pumpkins
is a
very important item.
Oh, that's so funny.
You're quite welcome here.
Great.
Boy, that's
a nonstop line. That's so funny. The flowers and the bucket of pumpkins. Who's that good looking dude, huh? Is this your house? Is this your house? It got your picture up on the mantelpiece. Must be your place, huh? Nice house. See this good looking dude in the corner over here, Mike? And as a surprise for Kim, the real maid of honor, I'll zoom in on her picture. And this was Mom's idea, not mine. She's a hottie. She's a hottie. Cool looking place. Changing room for the guys, so I think everybody's already changed into their stuff.
Except me.
He's cooling
the
off.
The AC is right there.
Now whose room is this?
This is the girls.
This is the girls' changing room in here. The glass is a little bit odd, so you can't really see them. Look at that pretty dress. Wow, you look so pretty.
Rather handsome.
Thank you.
Oh, I love your, what
hello.
Called? What are they called?
Now.
And by the way, the door is locked.
You want to sit on that?
You sit on this.
We, I guess we have to bring them. And Kim did it. Kim thought about it.
You fit in this environment perfectly. Smile. Look at this. There you go. Ah, that simple face. There you go.
My turn to say hello.
On behalf of Kim and Yancey, on this gorgeous evening which God has provided, we welcome you to this sacred celebration of their marriage to one another in the presence of the Lord God and of all of us, their family and friends. Together we all thank God who brought them together in His own unique way and ask Him to guide their way always. Of Kim's aunt, Karen Kress, whom we believe is also here in spirit and love.
St. Paul to the Corinthians. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and knowledge, and if I have faith not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-keeping, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres.
Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be sheltered to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there is no more loneliness for you, for each of you will be companion to the other. Now you are two bodies, but there is only one life before you. Now go to your dwelling place to enter into the days of your togetherness, and may your days be good and long upon the earth.
We know that people crave love all their life, lust. Actually, Kim and Yancey see love and willingness to forgive, humility and avoiding jealousy and anger, respecting them and helping them become the lover that they were meant by God to be. Well, that this takes work, but love will prevail and allow them to share as long as they shall live.
I answered.
Take you, Kim.
Take me, Kim.
Be my wife.
Be my wife.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
Honor you.
Honor you.
Respect you always.
And respect you always.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
I can.
Take you, Yancey.
Take you, Yancey.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
Honor you.
Honor you.
And respect you always.
And respect you always.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
Lord God, bless these rings which we are blessing in your name. May Kim and Yancey, who wear them, be ever faithful in their love for one another. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Kim?
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
Take this ring. As a sign of my love and fidelity.
Now, my friends, at this very solemn moment, this couple turns their mind to God and thank Him for all the blessings that they have received up to this moment. And with Christian hope, looking forward to the many blessings they'll receive from God until death do us part. Now, if you'll join them, please stand, and together we'll say the Lord's Prayer. Now, as a further symbol of the loving experience today, we're doing the kiss of peace. Lord Jesus, you said to your beloved friends, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our failings and our weaknesses, but on our faith in you, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where we live and where you live forever and ever. Amen. Now, my friends, if you would just express some sign of friendship and love with your neighbor.
Lord, grant that as they begin to live their marriage, they may share with each other and become one in heart and purpose. Help them create a home together, a family full of love. Give your blessings to Kim, your daughter, helping her to be a good wife and mother, loving, generous, and kind. Give your blessings also to Yancey, your son, helping him to be a caring husband and father, a faithful provider, patient, and respectful of his wife and family. And may they together enjoy the rewards of a good and happy life forever with you. And we ask this as always in your name. And I am now pleased to present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Yancey Durr.
People that slept here. That's Alexander Graham Bell, Pujan Therapur, Eric Arada, and George Washington slept here. It's amazing. It's Abraham Lincoln. Benjamin Franklin.
See, I was talking about
just said, is that one of my paint-by-number plates?
There's another one on that side.
Yes, we'll get that one too.
Yeah.
Just a little bit, right? I'll come back, right?
Okay. So pretty.
Under his breath, that's how he laughs.
He was working very hard at your wedding.
Yes.
Here. One more.
Thank you.
Spades Ushers. First, please welcome Elizabeth Cohen, escorted by Michael Radetsky, and one of our power girls, Libby Cohen. This is Butterfly by Lenny Kravitz. Let's have another nice big round of applause for them as they're dancing as husband and wife for the first time.
Those of you don't know me,
joining, I'm sure most of you do. I am Lisa Medeski, the very proud sister-in-law of our beautiful bride here. I'm going to try to get through this without crying, so. I want to start by congratulating you guys. Being the wife of Kim's protective older brother made me just as protective of Kim. So we both had a lot of expectations for you, which he met. So far, Yancey has lived up and exceeded all of our expectations. I don't think we can handpick a better person for Kim. Yancey really understands Kim and knows just what she needs and makes it happen. When I look at Kim and Yancey, I know they found their true match with each other. Separately, you are two special, remarkable people, but together you're complete. I love you both. Okay. Can't do any more of this mushy stuff. The first time Yancey was introduced to most of the Rodetsky family, let me just remind you how crazy this family can be. Yancey walked into our house and was promptly frisked down by our Uncle Bill. Yancey took it all in stride. So the fact that he stuck around after that first encounter, we knew we'd make it just fine in this family. Yancey, although you've been part of the Rodetsky family for many years now, I just wanted to officially welcome you. I love you guys. And again, congratulations.
For those don't know, I'm Yancey's brother, Dan. I first met Yancey April 11th, 1973, and she's been my best friend for over 35 years. But in those years, not only a good friend and a great brother, but a really good man. And our friendship is just amazing. And I look forward to building on that great friendship over the years with Kim, his lovely new bride. Yancey and Kim, you know, every great relationship starts with rings. You know, the phone rang. And just the excitement of talking to each other was just so exciting. You know, and then, of course, your love grew, and so did your commitment to one another. So, an engagement ring came. And, of course, you know, your love is strong, and we're here today to celebrate your marriage. Well, that ring, well, engagement ring turned into a wedding, of course, and we're here to celebrate that marriage. And of course, finally, the supper ring. Please, everybody raise your hands. And join me in celebrating this wonderful evening. Yancey and Kim, best of luck in your new future together. Cheers.
Very nice. So don't you like the round of applause? And at this time, we invite everybody into the dining room.
John, you missed the...
Oh, no.
Yeah. Well, it's birthday.
What is she doing here?
Oh, my God. I don't know if you could, if you would have hold it up for...
This is my long-lost sister.
It's Bertha.
I'm so glad
she's here in spirit.
Yes. Sick.
Yes.
Thank you.
I say, leave, and I say, bye.